Now let's further explore MC Basic through two examples. As mentioned earlier, MC Basic is too simple to be practically efficient, but it's crucial for understanding the idea of model-free reinforcement learning. Next, let's check these examples to clarify what this algorithm does. Let's look at this example. Consider an initial policy denoted as pi 0. In most states, this policy is good except for states S1 and S3, where it is not good. We will apply the MC Basic algorithm to find an optimal policy. Similar to policy iteration, MC Basic consists of two steps, as we've discussed before: policy evaluation and policy improvement. In policy evaluation, we need to compute Q pi KSA for all states S and all possible actions A. In our example, we have 9 states and 5 actions per state, totaling 45 state action pairs. So we need to find 45 Q pi K values. Assume that we have n trajectories starting from every SA, and then compute the average return of the n trajectories. Therefore, we need a total of 45 times n trajectories. After obtaining Q pi K, the next step is policy improvement, where we simply choose the action with the highest action value for each state. Due to time limitations, let's consider just one state, S1, and its 5 possible actions. First, we perform policy evaluation. As we mentioned earlier, starting from S1 A1, we need to find n trajectories, and then we calculate the average return of these n trajectories. Then, I can use the average to approximate Q pi KS1 A1. Since this example has a deterministic policy and environment, regardless of how many times I sample, the resulting trajectories will be the same. As a result, we only need to sample once to compute Q pi KS1 A1. Of course, in more complex scenarios with stochastic policies or environments, an infinite number of episodes, or at least many episodes, are required to compute an average. Now, let's examine the trajectory starting from state S1 and action A1. The trajectory would be going up from S1, then it comes back, goes up again, and comes back once more. This trajectory is S1, A1, S1, A1, S1, A1. We can then compute the return corresponding to this trajectory, which is Q pi 0 S1 A1. Apart from S1 A1, we also need to compute this for S1 A2, S1 A3, S1 A4, and S1 A5. The method for each of these is similar, and I won't go into further detail here. After deriving Q pi, the next step is to conduct policy improvement. In essence, this involves comparing the action values to see which one is the largest. In this case, A2 and A3 are the largest. You can go back to the previous slide for the specific values. Intuitively, moving right or down appears to be the better actions because they both yield the same action value. Therefore, either A2 or A3 can be chosen to form a new policy. This new policy is already optimal. One iteration is sufficient to find the optimal policy. That is because this example is simple in the sense that, besides A1, the policies of the surrounding states are already optimal. If this course were taught offline, I would pause for 5 minutes and ask the students to do an exercise, such as finding the optimal policy for S3 using the Monte Carlo Basic algorithm. For online teaching, you can decide according to your own situation. Here, I would like to emphasize that it is important to do some exercise, as it can help better understand the contents. Now let's consider the second example. In this example, we're not demonstrating how to use MC Basic to solve a problem, but rather assuming we've already obtained the optimal policy using MC Basic. We'll analyze some interesting properties of this optimal policy. Here we focus on the length of the episode. What does this mean? When using MC Basic, we require data, typically gathered from numerous episodes, by starting from any state and action. Ideally, the longer the episode is, the more accurate the return is. However, in reality, episodes cannot be infinitely long. So, what episode length should we select? Here, in this grid world example, we have different settings. Let's examine the results obtained from MC Basic. Optimal state value and optimal policy. The results are not good. Why? Because the episode length used here is only 1. What does this mean? It means that starting from state S, taking action A, it then jumps to a new state to receive a reward, and then jumps again to another state for another reward. However, an episode length of 1 means that it stops after this single transition, and no further actions are taken. Thus, only the reward obtained at this single step is used as the episode's return, which obviously is an inaccurate estimate of the action value. Now, let's pay attention to its properties. As you can see, only the states immediately adjacent to the target have positive values, and their corresponding policies are correct. All other values are 0, and their policies are not optimal. A value of 0 implies that these states never reach the target. Otherwise, reaching the target would yield a positive value. This observation is quite easy to understand. Let's imagine we're in a desert, and suppose there's a water source here. We intend to explore in all directions, but our exploration radius is limited to just 1 kilometer. If the water source is 5 kilometers away, no matter how we explore, we won't detect the water source. Therefore, any policy starting from this point would be incorrect. Conversely, if the water source is nearby, say within 1 kilometer, then our exploration radius is sufficient, and we can detect it. In this case, we know the policy should lead us to go up towards the water source. Thus, intuitively, the episode length can be understood as the length of the exploration radius. Now, let's see what happens when we increase the episode length. It's quite interesting. First, if the episode length is extended to 2, besides the previously correct states, the policies of these two states become correct as well. Why? Because starting from here, we can reach the target in exactly 2 steps, and starting from here, we can also reach the target in exactly 2 steps. The corresponding values are positive. However, the policy at this state appears correct, but is actually randomly generated, because all possible actions, up, left, and stay, yield 0 action values. So the left action is randomly chosen, resulting in a value of 0, meaning it's not intentionally chosen, since it doesn't lead to the target. It takes 3 steps to reach the target. If we further extend the episode length to 3 steps, this value becomes positive, indicating the correct policy. Continuing to increase the length gradually leads to the optimal policy. If we keep increasing it to a length of 14 steps, it means it takes 14 steps to reach the target from the starting point. Let's take a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. After reaching the target, we receive a positive return, and the corresponding value becomes positive. Similarly, at this state, going upward is essentially a random choice because its state value is 0, meaning it hasn't actually reached the target. It either stays still or goes upward, and it just happens to choose to go upward. However, when I increase the episode length to 15, it can reach the target. The evidence is that the state value here has become positive. If we continue to increase the episode length, for example, to 30 or 100, the policy basically remains unchanged. The only change is the state value, and the estimation of the optimal state value keeps changing. When the episode length is large, such as 100 or close to infinity, the estimated optimal state value is close to the true value. Through the example we just discussed, we've uncovered some interesting findings. Let's summarize. First, when the episode length is short, only the states that are close to the target can reach the target within such a limited number of steps and find the correct policy. However, as the episode length gradually increases, states farther from the target can also reach it over time, eventually finding the optimal policy. In essence, the episode length should be sufficiently long to allow all states have the opportunity to reach the target. However, it doesn't have to be infinitely long, it just needs to be sufficiently long. The specific lengths mentioned in our example, such as dozens or hundreds of steps, were provided for illustrative purposes. In practice, the appropriate length depends on the specifics of the problem at hand and should be analyzed accordingly.